I made a XXIO driver for less than 300 bucks. What's happening, Panda Nation? Peter Von Panda here. Hey, I was actually golfing with a buddy of mine who had XXIO clubs. If you're not familiar with them, XXIO, XXIO, are the most popular brand of clubs in Asia. And one of the things that they have done here is just double down on saying, we're gonna build clubs for our demographic, which maybe tends to be a little shorter, tends to be a little weaker, tends to have a little slower swing speed. Now, a lot of people say that XXIO clubs are meant for senior citizens, but I'll tell you what, I think a lot of people could benefit from them. Even when I have played around with the weights in my driver, actually going down a little bit of weight because I do hit the sweet spot fairly often. I actually don't need as much weight in other places that are designed to give you more forgiveness, so I can strip out some of that weight and get my club head speed up and get a little more distance. So XXIO has found this formula where they build some really lightweight clubs, irons, and drivers, but they are very, very expensive, and so that is one of the problems here. This is the XXIO Prime. This is a driver I would love to check out, but as you can see here, it has a $900 retail price, and it is very, very light, 254 grams in total, including the head, shaft, and grip. And one of the things that I thought here was, I wonder if there's a way so that more people of all stripes can have the benefits of a XXIO driver, but at a fraction of the cost. So what I did here was build this little bad boy. And I have been hitting this, taking it to the range, and I love it. And if you want this, I'm gonna give you the formula for it. So XXIO seems to make all their components, and you can't actually buy them separately. They are kind of all built to spec. You actually can't even customize it. You actually just order the set that matches you best. Now, one of the things that is really nice about components is that you can buy what you want, put them together, and actually get everything tailored to you. Now, I actually think that this driver that I'm holding in my hand right here is actually superior in some ways to the XXIO. So let me tell you what I've got here. First of all, this driver head is a light speed driver by Titanium Golf Works. I've actually ordered several of these heads because I've fallen in love with them. As you can see, I have played this. This is an all titanium head, and yet it's very light. So what I've done here is taken out all of the excess weight. So what it comes with are these little plastic plugs. So those are only like a gram, but you can get some brass weights to put in there. They come with the club head, which is tremendous. And then there are these two little skid bars on the bottom, and this one is removable, and that's something like a 7 or 8 gram weight. So I've taken that out too. Now what that's going to do is it's going to remove a little bit of that low weighting, a little bit of this draw bias here. But like I said, even in this configuration, a full length driver, I can hit this just nice and straight, and you can tell that there's not a lot of weight here. The other way that they save weight is that this is just a glue-in head. There's no adjustable hosel here. So what you want to do is you want to order this in the loft that you need. Now, for a lot of people, especially with slower swing speeds, you might want the highest loft possible, and I think that's a 12 degree. This one's in a 9.5 degree, and I've been hitting this, and I really, really love it. I'll tell you what, you don't have to be a senior citizen to actually get the benefits from this. But I will tell you, if you get this head, use these plastic plugs in here, remove the 7 gram weight here, and because it doesn't have an adjustable hosel, you don't have a separate adapter that you have to weigh. This comes in at 172 grams, which is actually pretty incredible. Now, you might be saying, well, Pete, most heads are about 200 grams. Isn't that what is necessary to have enough momentum to hit the ball? And I would say that from my sleuthing on the internet, I have found that people have been testing very lightweight heads. And if you get down to about 170, you start having diminishing returns. So you really need about 170 grams or more at the head to kind of maintain the velocity of the golf ball. So this is above that, 172 grams. It's kind of a minimum weight here, but I tell you what, I haven't been having a problem hitting this over 200 yards, all right? So let's go on. Now, the other amazing thing about this light-speed head is it's available in an offset version. So if you have a tendency to slice, fade it, maybe even hard, it'll come with an offset hosel here that's about 5 grams more, but that really does help your slice. I have that club head too, and I've tried that, and it certainly does help you dial in a draw. Now, the best thing about this is the head itself with the extra weight kit is about 150, 160 bucks. So in terms of golf club driver heads, it's one of the cheapest ones I could find too, and it certainly has been a champ. I've used this on the course and at the driving range. It's actually been one of the best heads I've ever had. So, light speed head, component number one. All right, let's talk about this shaft here. This is actually a Pro Launch Blue. It's by Graphalloy, and this is their 45. Now, you can get this in a variety of flexes, and my guess is that for most people, what you want to get is in an A flex. Now, this one is in an R flex. Now, what's interesting about this in the regular flex, it's still pretty flexible, but the A flex is actually more flexible, so if you have a slower swing speed, that's going to help you get a little bit of additional club head speed with it, but the R flex is actually a little lighter than the A flex for whatever reason. The R flex is actually 44 grams and the A flex is 48 grams. I don't think those 4 grams distributed along the shaft here is going to make that much of a difference. So even if you are fastidious about trying to get the club weight down, I would still probably go with the flex that is appropriate for you. But even at 48 grams, that is a very, very light shaft. In fact, when you look at other really light shafts like the Grand Bassara or the Auto Flex that get into that range too, you're talking about a $400 shaft and an $800 shaft. And that's where these shafts, the Pro Launches, are fantastic. One, because they're light. I've used these in my woods, my drivers, in a lot of clubs, obviously in this one, and they are a fantastic shaft at an incredible price. So this shaft here, if you buy it in its raw form, is only about $70, which actually puts it at the lower end of what shafts cost, and I will tell you that I have really liked this. So the Graphalloy Pro Launch Blue 45, $70, 45 grams. That's component number two. Now the last thing, and this is where you actually have an advantage, as I was saying, over the XXIO, because you can put on any grip that you want. Now the one I would recommend here is the Win Dry Tack Light, and that's because these grips are very light. Now, I would actually recommend one of two grips, and if I show you the butt end here, it says mid-sized right there. Now, the Win Dry Tack comes in a mid-size, which is just a little bit thicker than standard, and it also comes in an oversized, which is a little bit thicker than the mid-size. And to me, I actually use the oversized because even though I don't suffer from arthritis or anything, what that does is it gives me more surface area to get my hands on there, and I feel like I have more control without gripping harder. So if you do have some hand problems, some arthritis, maybe you have big hands, maybe you can't clamp your hand down as well as you used to, maybe you want to just take out the wrist turn, whatever, I think if you go to the Win Dry Tack light grips here in the mid-size or oversized, and really if you have smaller hands and you might want to stick with the midsize, then you can't go wrong because you're going to get a grip that fits your hand better than the standard grips. On top of that, the lights are actually very, very light. This grip here is only 32 grams. In the oversize, it's only 33 grams. So they are about the same size as any of the standard grips that are just rubber. Right? Those can actually be 45 grams, 50 grams for some of those. The standard cheap grips that come on a lot of golf clubs are actually quite heavy. Now, you can get some grips that are even a little bit lighter, down to 27, 28 grams, but I think that going a little larger, giving yourself a little more purchase here, and sacrificing those 4 extra grams is worth it to me. Now, let's go ahead and talk about the whole thing in general, right? So, light speed head, Pro Launch Blue Shaft, Win Dry Tack Light, mid-sized or oversized grip here. What we have here is a total club that is only 253 grams for all of its components. Now, I'm actually throwing in a few extra grams because you're going to use a little epoxy down here and a piece of grip tape up here. So I think you might have 2 or 3 more grams. However, if you do trim your driver a little bit, and I would say for most people you should, so if you're using a 45-inch driver, I would absolutely suggest looking at a 44 or 43-inch driver, so you might lose a few grams there. So 250 grams, I think, is your target weight on this. Now, if I look at the XXIO spec sheet here, like I said, the XXIO Prime driver is 254 grams is what it advertises as its final weight. So 253 grams, 254 grams, basically, we have made a XXIO driver in terms of weight. Now, as I mentioned, I actually think we're superior because we have a better grip here. But what have we done in terms of price? The XXIO driver is $899. $900 effectively for that driver, which I will say, if that is going to improve your golf game and make it more enjoyable, that could be worth every penny. But total for this is $229 for component 1, 2, and 3. And my guess is that you'll have to pay $30 to have it assembled if you can't do it at home. To be honest, if you live near me, I'll put it together for you for free because it's just a little epoxy and then installing a grip on the shaft here. So $229, and let's round up because let's say you buy these components, take it to your local PGA Tour, Superstore, Golf Galaxy, that type of thing, and have them assemble it. You're looking at maybe $260. $260 versus $900. That's pretty amazing. That is $650 to $670 cheaper than the XXIO driver, and I think you're getting all of the same benefits. And does this hold up? As you can see there from the face, little ball marks, I have taken this to the driving range and pounded it around quite a bit. Yes, even with my slow swing speed, on a great day, I am really clicking and really getting into it. I can get my swing speeds up to 90 plus miles an hour, but in most cases, a controlled swing for me is right around the 82, 83 mile per hour range. If you're swinging even slower than that, I think you're gonna benefit from a little additional loft, but I can absolutely put this out there, 175 to 200 plus when I'm really going at it. So if you are looking for a XXIO driver and don't have the scratch or don't want to spend the scratch on a $900 driver, check this out. I'll put a link to the head, the shaft, and the grip in the description below so that you can build yours and save a ton of money. Peter Von Panda, out.
We can discover more and explore so much deeper.